The maritime collision of a fishing boat and a crude oil tanker that led to the deaths of three Filipino fishermen is unrelated to territorial disputes in the West Philippine Sea. That assertion from the Philippine Coast Guard, which said the incident happened far from Scarborough Shoal. The PCG says it cannot categorically conclude whether the oil tanker MV Pacific Anna was involved in the incident, since the probe is still underway. But the Coast Guard has already written to the government of Marshall Islands, where the boat is registered, to seek clarifications. The PCG also wrote to Singapore's port, since a tanker is heading there.
The Philippine Coast Guard has already reached out, no, sa port state control ng vessel of interest na sinusubaybayan natin ngayon. We're going to we have already coordinated with them for them to be subject to much more thorough investigation and to confirm kung ang barko na ito ay dumaan sa area na sinasabi ng mga mangingisda in the specific time and date na nilahad din nila.
The Philippine Coast Guard successfully conducts another resupply mission to the country's lone outpost at the Ayungin Shoal. That's despite what the Coast Guard described as harassment and interference from its Chinese counterparts. On Wednesday, the PCG reported a Chinese Coast Guard vessel once again performed dangerous maneuvers in an attempt to block the resupply ships. Maritime security expert Ray Powell says two Chinese militia ships passed within meters of the Philippine vessels. Powell earlier said at least three Chinese vessels were in the area, with some 12 Chinese militia ships poised to enforce a blockade.
95% of Filipinos have spent more on food within the past 3 months, according to a new Pulse Asia survey. 83% said they spent more on rice in particular. More than half of the respondents said they have also reduced food consumption within the same time. The survey was conducted from September 10 to 14 among 1,200 respondents. Now, during that period, an executive order was issued setting a price ceiling on rice.
The Philippine Coast Guard has its hands full in patrolling the West Philippine Sea and responding to maritime disasters, which is why the agency is reiterating its call to quickly modernize its assets. Coast Guard spokesperson Rear Admiral Armand Balilo says they are in dire need of additional ships, advanced technology, and the establishment of more piers. Balilo also says they also need to beef up their manpower to better protect the country's coastlines. Aside from physical assets, the Coast Guard official also underscored the importance of intelligence funds in collecting information and surveillance activities.
Gumaganap kami sa isang maritime security operation, law enforcement activities, hindi lamang sa West Philippine Sea. Napakarami nating sinabi ko nga kayo na dapat bantayan. Kailangan natin yung intel funds to upgrade our system, yung human intelligence natin, ma-improve natin. Yung ating mga gadgets, yung mga technology, kailangan natin ma-improve para ma-improve natin yung ating surveillance, yung mga measures natin sa pagmamanman at sa pagkukolek ng information.
More countries are expressing interest to boost defense ties with the Philippines. Defense Chief Gilberto Teodoro Jr. says the Netherlands is looking to establish deeper cooperation in the field of naval defense. The secretary said this was proposed by the Dutch ambassador to Manila during a courtesy call earlier this week. The Netherlands is known for its naval industries, particularly in building high-quality patrol ships and submarines. Teodoro says aside from defense, there are other areas where both countries can expand a partnership, including on cybersecurity and artificial intelligence.
Moving on, Makati City files a petition to be allowed to continue governing over the so-called Embo villages. Now, this comes months after the Supreme Court ruled that area belongs to Taguig City. Our correspondent, Willard Chang, now on the line with that story. Willard?
Hi, Ron. The city of Makati filed at the Taguig Regional Trial Court an urgent motion for clarification with prayer for the issuance of a status quo ante order. Makati Mayor Abby Binay led the filing of the petition. If granted, Binay said, the effect will be Makati will be allowed to govern over the so-called Embo barangays, while there is still no clear plan to implement the Supreme Court's decision on the border dispute between Makati and Taguig. Binay reiterated she respects and does not oppose the Supreme Court, but said a writ of execution as well as a clear plan is needed to properly implement the High Court's decision. A clarification from the court, she added, will help avoid confusion in the delivery of services to the affected residents. Still, she said, Makati continues to render services to affected residents, including education and free medication in the Hospital na Makati, for example.
The reason why we're asking for a status quo order is again to maging maayos yung transition. Kasi ang problema, namimili sila kung ano yung gusto nilang kunin. Diba? Kaya ang point nga ng magkaroon ng writ of execution, it is a plan. Kasi hindi lang naman to school, hindi lang naman to health services, paano yung garbage, paano yung kuryente, paano yung fire, paano yung disaster, ang dami pa, super dami. Pero sila, pinipili lang muna nila, ito lang gusto ko. Tsaka ito lang gusto ko lang ito. Hindi, it doesn't work that way. It has to be one complete plan and comprehensive transition.
The petition was filed at the Taguig RTC, Binay pointed out, because the Supreme Court has already remanded the case records to the lower court. Ron, back to you.
Willa Chang with that story, thanks. The brother of slain radio man Percy Lapid slams vloggers who interview the alleged mastermind behind Lapid's death. Roy Mabasa questions whether it was legal for the vloggers to interview former prison's chief Gerald Bantag since there's a warrant out for his arrest. He warns other content creators against providing platforms to fugitives like Bantag. Bantag is wanted for allegedly orchestrating the death of Lapid, who was shot near his home in Las Piñas City last year.
Nakakapagtaka na yung mga vloggers nakikita siya, samantalang yung mga otoridad ay hindi siya makita. Yun lang yung sa amin. I refuse to acknowledge his existence dahil kapag binigyan ko pa ng pansin yan, mabubwisit lang kaming pamilya. No? Pabayaan mo na siyang magsalita dyan sa mga vloggers at sama-sama silang magkaroon ng kaso. Sapagkat yan ay paglabag sa ating batas na yung isang pugante ay nai-interview at nagpapakita sa YouTube at Facebook. Mm-mm.